Hello everyone, welcome to Xinhua Live. I'm Lei Jiaxing with Xinhua News Agency. Today we are in Qinzhou, a city of South China's Guangxi, also called the city of Nixing pottery. And today we are going to show you Nixing pottery. Now I'm holding a teapot. This is one of the Nixing pottery. And this year marks the 60th anniversary of Guangxi Zhuang Autonomous Region, and we are doing a series of light show to present you the beauty of this beautiful place. Okay, and now we are at the Nixing Pottery Cultural Industrial Park. Today we are going to show you the procedure, how a Nixing pottery is made, and the unique feature behind it. Nixing pottery is originated in 1,300 years ago, probably in the Tang Dynasty, and was well developed in the Qing Dynasty. This is Mr. Zhou Changyuan, and he is an expert of the Nixing pottery making. Okay, let's see around. Okay, we see a quite special one here. This is one of the Nixing
pottery. Qinzhou
is famous for white dolphin, and this one, we can see that it is a dolphin. Yeah, it's a sculpture of Nixing pottery. Okay, now we are going to see Mr. Zhou's pottery making process.
现在我们做的这一个工序是拉胚，都是用泥把它拉成，先拉成这个形状。
we are doing a shaping procedure. Now we have the original materials, and after the shaping, we can have a original shape of a Nixing pottery.
先把这个泥固定一个盘，等一下拉了它可以取下来。固定是吧？对，固定一个底座，因为拉了每一个拉了要拿下来啊，这样子揉好的。你稍微要远一点点，怕进沾那个泥浆哦。
现在我们做的这一个像是做出一个想要做出一个什么样的东西呢？做成像这个花瓶，啊，我。Okay,
now
we are doing a Nixing pottery, and it's going to be a vase like this. Now we are shaping.
这么拉一个胚大概要多久啊？嗯，十来分钟吧。
Well, the shaping procedure is will take about like 10 minutes. The young come here, and they like doing this. It's a cultural thing, yeah.
Sir, you. 现在拉了30多年了，从小在家里也是，也是随着父亲也是做这个陶的。
Mr. Zhou has been working on the pottery making for like over 30 years, and his father and his grandpa also doing this job.
这个形状是可以根据你的这一个力度啊，各方面就随意变换是吧？对，就是随着自己心，如果有个样板都，就照着这个样板，随着心中要有这个形，你拉的时候就知道拉高拉矮呀、啊，就是把它拉出哪里，就是意思。
It can be shaped whatever you want if you use different.
像通常我们做完一个作品大概要花多久呀？通常一个作品就是把它做好了再通过晾干，它分那个天，如果天好的时候它干得快一点就修胚快一点，如果通常一个作品的话，从拉到晾干的话要三四天吧，因为它要晾干了还要修胚。
Normally a work like this, if it is done, it needs like 3 days or 4 days.
Like 像我们做这一个就整个流程啊，大概分为几个步骤呢？大概分为，如果从面泥过后就是分为五个步骤。分别是什么步骤呢？就是拉胚、修胚、再雕刻、烧窑、再打磨。
There are generally 5 steps for this pottery get done. They are shaping, polishing, craving, carving, and firing. When we are doing this, we have to make our hands steady. We can be shaky or the pottery will get ugly.
我们先把下面这个形拉出来了，再拉上面，因为后面收口嘛，收了口了，它手都进不来了。
Okay, we are doing this from the bottom to the top. It will be much easier for the final steps.
这两边的泥是用来做什么的呀？就是辅助这个盘儿，辅助这个底座。把它等一下，我拉好就可以把它这个一取都可以把它拿下来了。
The mud around here, they are for making the wheel steady. After we are doing.
我们都开始收那个口了。
Yeah, we are closing in on the top. Yeah, we are shaping it step by steps. As we can see, it needs a lot of works.
像初学者玩这一个的话，要注意一些什么样的东西呢？嗯，要注意，要先要练，跟练功一样，要手要稳，要把它练得手稳，要不要让它泥巴摆来摆去，要就是要练到这个怎么说，就是要你随心所欲，要那个泥巴听你自己的，哎，你想怎么弄就怎么弄，就是要手稳，初学主要是要手稳。
For the first learners, we have to make our hands steady, then we can be good at it. For the first learners, we can start with the small potteries. Potteries like cup, teapot, vase, things that are round. That can be made on this wheel. We can do this. This is the original type, stereotype. We need polishing after this to make it more smoother. This is the first step of pottery making, Nixing pottery making. After this, we need this to be air dried, then we can polish it and carve some patterns on it. Okay. Okay, this is the first step. Yeah.
Wait.
Okay, now. Now I'm going to try this. This is my first time doing this. Try to make a pottery. This mud around here, therefore the static. Yeah, and now I'm trying it. We put some water on it and it can be smooth and not dirty.
三，你的两个手要在膝盖上这样，要有一点力，你的手要稳，一定要手稳。如果你手不稳，它的跟着这个泥巴动来动去。
I'm putting my head, my knee, hands on the on my knees.
你像这个手，我给你感觉一下，你手不用随着泥巴转。
Oh. You need some strength.
先要把泥巴扶正，要把它找到中心。
You need to find your center.
如果你不找在中心的话，它都会摆来摆去，你没办法拉。现在我们现在是要用力是吧？也得。要用点力，把那泥巴要扶在中心。
I need to push it harder.
我给你放一点水。先我给你放在中心先。你要是感觉到那个泥巴的话，它是。 在中心了，不会动来动去了，你都可以开一个孔下去。
I'm making a hole on it. 是就这么戳进去吗？还是？把它压，指头往里面压。往下压，用力一点。对，手可以伸起来。对，使劲压下去。哦。
对。
Now we have a big hole.
对，你不要压到那个底，估计留得到有一个底都行了。再把它收回。
It's not easy. It's not an easy work.
你开始可能手不稳。
如果我想让它大一点的话，我是用力往里面。不是，要这样子把它弄来，要这样子把它拉。
你往外面的话，它都会大。你看，你想拉一个像个碗的形状。
It's like a bowl now.
你不能太过于开了，先把里面把它压。这样子慢慢弄。 往上面提这个泥，往上面用两个手纹。
You can be whatever you want.
这样慢慢提
with your force on your hand.
你都可以照着你的想法怎么样提啊，怎么样大小啊，做的怎么样的形状。如果你要小的往里面拉，你手感觉不滑了，你要沾一点水。沾一点水，它手才有润滑，它才不会沾着泥。
And I want it to be taller, perhaps this.
看你手不稳，它都会歪，一歪了，它都没办法拉了。 主要是开始要手稳。
During the process, you have to make your hand steady. This is an important key.
其实你如果找到中心了，它都不用那么出那么大的力了。如果你没找到中心，你的手老是在动来动去的时候，它就你要把它伸大一点，你都里面放一只手，外面一只手，里面一只手。
Like this?
像这样哈。你随便开始你怎么顺手都怎么弄一下先，因为开始一说这个感觉，你一下也可能也找不到。
Yeah, this is my first time doing this. It's not easy.
Okay, we today introduce you the procedure how a Nixing pottery is made and the unique features behind it. And we can show all the details in such a short live show. So if you come to Qinzhou next time, you can come here and find more details about it. Okay, with this, we'll wrap our live show here. And we hope you enjoy our show. And if you like it, please share it on your YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter with your friends. Okay, thank you. See you next time.